Now, before we tip this game off, they're actually honoring today also the legendary Ray Meyer. Coach passed away last March, ironically on St. Patrick's Day at the age of 92, a day that he enjoyed as much as anyone out there. Family members, former players, they're all here to participate in the festivities for the coach today. 34 of Coach Ray's 42 teams are represented at today's ball game. We just saw the athletic director, Jeannie Ponsetto, and one of her assistants, Peter Tombosco, as we get set to play on the Ray and Marge Meyer Court here at Allstate Arena.
Quite a tribute for quite a coach who had as much effect off the court for his young men as he did on the court. He is dearly missed by many, not just in this area, but in college basketball in general.
DePaul's also honoring Coach Ray. You just got to look at the uniforms. They're actually redesigned this year, and they were inspired from the days when Meyer was head coach. There's also a memorial patch designed in a red, white, and blue basketball. You can see it there on Caron Clark's, actually the left part of his chest on the uniform. It's a red, white, and blue basketball with the number 42 representing the amount of years that Coach Ray coached here at DePaul, and the number 724 for his 724 victories with the Blue Demons. Chandler and Arthur to tip this one off. And they are excited here at Allstate Arena. Jayhawks and Blue Demons. They'll re-jump it.
They're going to do it again. You mentioned the jerseys if we look at Coach Wainwright, but the jerseys are old school, Lou. This is back in the Terry Cummings, Teddy Grubbs days. And they're hoping that these jerseys bring them some of the success that they had back in the day.
That's the freshman, Will Walker, with the basketball. He moved into the starting lineup a couple of games ago. And despite being a freshman, he's a tough-nosed kid. His coach loves him on the floor. Doesn't play like a freshman. Down low, Clark working on Chalmers. Mejia for three. Nice start for the Blue Demons.
Good inside-out action. I like the fact that DePaul has picked up on a mismatch. Caron Clark at 6'6 is being guarded by Mario Chalmers at 6'1. They'll look to exploit that matchup.
Mejia, through six games this season, has really started slowly in basketball games and then had better second half, so that's a nice sign. Arthur, top of the key. Doesn't get the bounce. Walker pulls it down.
Will Walker is a talented young freshman out of Bolingbrook, Illinois. Coach Wainwright really expects a lot of him, especially in the leadership department.
Mejia trying to be aggressive there against rush defending, but he walks with the basketball.
I like the fact that DePaul's coming with some full court pressure, just trying to get Kansas, not looking for the steal necessarily, but trying to get them off of their P's and Q's and get them out of sync early.
Nearly 3-0 lead. Chalmers, defended by Chandler, tried to go baseline, back up top right. He'll take that three if you don't jump on him.
You see DePaul doing a really good job of double teaming in the corners.
Right there, had it, lost it. DePaul on the move. Mejia to Chandler, knocked away. Good defensive play by Rush, got back.
That's the effort that Wainwright wants to see out of his talented sophomore forward Wilson Chandler on both ends of the floor. Ran the floor extremely hard that time. He'd like to see it on both ends.
Leading scorer for the Blue Demons, Wilson Chandler, 15 points a game, but his head coach wants him to shoot even more. And he does. Short. Chalmers pushes it ahead. Has numbers. Thought about it. Gets it to Rush. Crowd wanted a travel call. Right. Double team. Looking for room, but he's fouled on the floor.
Coach Wainwright is not wanting Julian Wright to get started early. So he's going on the trap on the pass. Trying to double team Julian Wright in the post. The young man is playing with a lot of confidence so far, Lou.
Foul was on Chandler. First foul called in this game, and there's Wright. Just under 13 points a game. Deadly from anywhere. 62% field goal shooter.
And really a good look for Kansas and Julian Wright that time.
Walker all the way to the bucket. No one picked it up. And he laid it up and in. The
DePaul has to be careful, though. They don't want to get in a track meet with Kansas because Kansas can run with the best of them.
Jayhawks with great depth as well. Right? Jumper almost missed everything, just skimmed the rim.
Coach Self not happy with Julian Wright's decision that time. Had Lorenzo Thompson on him, not quite as quick, and he could have put it on the floor and gotten a better shot.
Ron Clark, call for the offensive foul. Chalmers took a flop.
Good decision by DePaul to try to exploit the mismatch, but not good execution. They need to shift the defense a couple times, maybe bring Karan from the weak side to the strong side post and give him a little bit of time to operate.
Good call. Clark, a guy who's 6'6", and Chalmers just 6'1". Kansas, no problem, breaking the press, and Rush pulls up and hits the three.
Rush is a young man who has All-American potential. And when he figures out how good he really is, Lou, he'll start to play at that level each and every night. Still doesn't understand the talent that he possesses. Take a look, and DePaul, you don't see anybody in the screen right there because they beat the first wave of pressure. No one stopped the basketball. Rush walks into a practice three from the top of the key.
We had a chance to chat with Coach Self, who you just saw there last night at the team shoot-around, and physically, he knows on the basketball court his team is as good as any in the country. He's worried with the mental makeup of his club.
The mental makeup, because they're so young, Lou, they don't play any seniors, and we see Chandler smiling after that tray in the corner, but they don't play any seniors. They're very young. Wright, Rush are sophomores, Chalmers a sophomore, Darrell Arthur a freshman, so there's still a lot of unknown with this young Jayhawks ball club night in, night out.
Three sophomores, one freshman, one junior starting for the Jayhawks. Wright almost lost it, double team, and he walked with it. Draylen Burns into the game, Wilson Chandler, they both double team Wright and forced him into the turnover.
Well, Julian Wright looks like he's pressing a little bit. Coach Self trying to talk to him, sending him to the bench. But you knew he was going to try to be aggressive. He's coming home, got a lot of people here. He wants to make a good impression. Looks like he's forcing the action, exactly what Bill Self is telling him right now.
Julian Wright grew up in Chicago Heights, just outside of the city, as Walker almost lost it on the floor, gets it to Burns. And Burns lost it, but it went off of Rush, so it will stay with DePaul.
I'm noticing a trend early in the game, Lou. DePaul is scoring by one-on-one activity. Kansas is scoring by moving the basketball and sharing the rock. DePaul needs to share the ball a little bit more, get some more guys involved.
Clark tried to share it with Walker there, threw it away. Clint Scales comes back, Walker to take a seat. Kansas, a team, Stephen, that averages 18 assists per game.
Yeah, they love playing with each other, and their chemistry is tremendous. And when you have guys like Chalmers and Russell on the floor that are can play one or two positions, Rush, who can play a guard position, it makes it easy to share the rock.
Knocked out of bounds there by Clark. Timeout on the floor. DePaul off to a nice start against the fifth-ranked Jayhawks, thanks in part to Wilson Chandler's three. DePaul's made three of its first four shots. They lead the Jayhawks by 3-8-5. College basketball action continues here on ESPNU following this Blue Demons Jayhawks game. UAB takes on Cincinnati. Then at 7 Eastern, Wichita State and Syracuse do battle. College basketball on ESPNU Saturday.
Wichita State team might be one of the surprises early in the college basketball season, representing the Missouri Valley Conference extremely well.
A couple of surprises we've seen early on this season. A number of mid-majors, or so-called mid-majors, taking down the big boys as Arthur knocks down the two.
That's right. Oral Roberts took down this Kansas ball club in Lawrence and did it in impressive fashion. Missouri State beating Wisconsin. A number of different, as you said, so-called mid-majors putting it to the big boy.
Coming back, Chalmers.
Take a look at that last play. Darrell Arthur, one of the most talented freshmen in the country, taking his time along the baseline. Lou, this young man has poise like he's been on this level before. We saw it in the Florida game. He clutched free throws down the stretch in overtime to seal the win for Kansas.
Shot clock down to six. DePaul will have to do something quickly. Down to two. Burns throws it up. Shot clock violation. DePaul never allowed to get in its offense.
DePaul looks disjointed early, Lou. They just haven't found rhythm since Mejia hit the three. They've been a little disjointed, not able to get into their offensive sets. Clean Scales, who's the point guard right now, has to do a better job of getting those guys to the position.
We should give some credit to the defense played by Kansas as well. They're one of the best defensive teams under Bill Self in his three seasons in the country. Turn over there for DePaul. Burns. Three defenders. Found Mejia. Clean Scales was open for a moment. Boy, is Chalmers quick.
That's illustrating that defense you were just talking about, Lou. Helping recover is one thing that Bill Self teaches and teaches well. And he's got the athletes to pull it off with those guys on the floor right now.
They've held every opponent under 50% shooting this year in Self's three seasons. Kansas has led the Big 12 and been ranked in the top eight nationally in field goal percentage defense.
And look at Sharon Collins and Julian Wright pressure the ball out top, keeping the Demons out of their offense. You see they're just standing around looking for someone to go one-on-one. You're not going to beat the Jayhawks all afternoon like that.
Green tried going one-on-one there with Jackson, missed everything. Sharon Collins back home, grew up in the Chicagoland area, on the floor now for Kansas. That's Collins with the basketball. Right. Rush, hop, skip, jump, the floater, knocked around, on the floor, Clink Scales comes out with it.
Good offensive possession despite the missed shot by Kansas. They got multiple touches, good looks at the basket.
Boy, nice no-look pass there to Clink Scales. Green had it rejected. Collins back the other way, he lost it. And a foul on the floor, Jackson called for the foul, his first. Team third.
Well, that's the big fella we talked about in the open. Keith Butler seeing his first action of the season for Wainwright. A question for me and you, Lou, for this big man. How's his conditioning going to be here this afternoon with the Gazelles that Kansas puts on the floor?
Butler was suspended in June for violations of team policy. He was eligible by the NCAA and university standards, but not Wainwright standards. He was able to use DePaul facilities, but he could not work out with the team. So you're right. He hasn't been able to go through a practice with a coaching staff supervising him. So just how much can he play in a game like this against a team like Kansas that's so deep?
They're going to have to play him in spot minutes. And you see Bill Self counter with Sasha Khan, seven-footer of his own.
Walker's three falls. Will Walker, freshman out of Bolingbrook High School in Bolingbrook, Illinois. Puts DePaul up four.
Well, DePaul has brought the energy from the start this afternoon. Something that Coach Wainwright was concerned with. But with a packed house and with a nationally ranked ball club, you figured they would bring it, Lou.
Jerry Wainwright's bringing it. Watch him on the sidelines. He's fired up. Loves the defense that his team has played so far.
Ron Collins ball hawking Will Walker. Will's going to have to tighten up that handle a little bit. A little loose out there.
Mejia has it poked away there by Russell Robinson. Back the other way. Robinson fouled, going to the bucket by Marcus Hurd. And Robinson will go to the line. For the Blue Demons, that's the third team foul, first on Hurd.
Now when Sammy Mejia makes this drive, his teammate Jabari Curry has to scream at him that Russell's coming behind. Heads up play by Robinson. Coming up with the pick. Solid guard. I like this guy, Lou. Does a tremendous job on the glass from the point guard position.
Yeah, averages almost four rebounds a game. Solid defender. Great quickness. We just saw it.
And when you have a team this talented, you need guys that aren't so concerned with scoring the rock. Robinson can do it when called upon, but his job is to feed the other big fellas like Darrell Arthur, Russ, and Julian Wright.
Well, Coach Self told us, you're not going to find a 20-point-per-game scorer on my team. We share the basketball. All five starters for Kansas returning from last year's squad, a squad that finished up 25-8 but lost in the first round of the NCAA tournament to Bradley. Second straight year they lost in the first round of the tournament.
And I think that showed their youth in terms of them getting into a tournament situation. It got a little bit tight, and they lost to an outstanding Bradley ball club that made it to the Sweet 16.
Yeah, not to take anything away from the Braves, who surprised a lot of people. Burns threw it up, no. Butler had a shot at it. Here comes Collins. He's got Rush behind him. Over to Kahn!
And right here, this is where you see Butler is not able to keep up with Kahn running the floor that time. You have to keep a close eye on Keith Butler and see how his wind is right now.
Mejia and Chandler getting ready to check back for DePaul.
DePaul's just standing. There's no continuity to their offense right now. They've got to get ball movement, bodies moving, and guys in position to do something with it.
There's Butler against Kahn. Works his way around, has it rejected. Wright came over to help out. Chalmers pulls up for three and hits. And Kansas is in front for the first time. Kansas in front. They're deep. Sasha Kahn, the 6'11" center, off the bench. Sasha Kahn off the bench. Part of the reason why Kansas now leads DePaul 13-11. Stephen, DePaul hit three of its first four shots ever since that timeout when they were ahead 8-6. Play has been controlled by Kansas. What have the Jayhawks done defensively?
They've turned the screws up defensively. They're ball hawking, meaning that whoever has the ball for DePaul, Kansas is in their face, not allowing them to initiate any kind of offense.
Chandler into the paint, too hard. Mejia follows.
Sammy Mejia can play the point guard position, but I like him at the two or the threes. Real crafty around the basket. That time sneaking in for the offensive rebound.
Second bucket for Mejia. He has five, tied at 13. Rush lost his balance. Turns it over. Pace has been fast and furious here just outside of Chicago at Allstate Arena. We're tied at 13. DePaul and Kansas tied at 13, a homecoming for a couple of Jayhawks, isn't it?
Yeah, Julian Wright and Sharon Collins. First, Julian Wright was a dynamo of a player at Homewood Flossmoor High School. South suburbs native. Julian put his team on his back, me and Knight down there, and then you look at Sharon Collins from Crane High School. It was a tremendous three-sport star. Baseball, football, and basketball.
I'm told Wright had to come up with 16 tickets. Collins needed 30 tickets for today's ball game.
And I believe the Crane High School basketball team is here in support of Sharon as well.
Speaking of Crane, Lorenzo Thompson of DePaul, as the Blue Demons give it up. Lorenzo Thompson played with Sharon Collins at Crane High School.
Sixth turnover on the afternoon for DePaul. Sticky defense by the Jayhawks.
Robinson finds Kahn. First a foul. Second foul. Actually, they give it to Hurd. First foul on Hurd.
Russell is putting a lot of pressure on the DePaul defense with his penetration here. Been very judicious with his chances in probing the defense off the bounce. That's that passing you were talking about right there, Lou. Julian Wright coming up the lane with a no-look cross-court pass. You just don't find many guys at his size can do that in college basketball.
Collins fighting his way around, and he lays it up and in. Boy, he took Walker to school there.
Yeah, put him on his hip pocket and took him all the way to the hole. You know these young men have played against each other in the summers here in the Chicagoland area.
Collins with great strength. Look at his base. He played football, was a terrific wide receiver in high school, actually, in one game, set a Chicago Public League school record with 275 receiving yards. And he could have played football and baseball in college.
That's right. 90-mile-an-hour fastball from what we hear. So this guy, whatever kind of ball it is, he could probably do it.
Boy, Mejia had an opportunity there to follow the miss. Knocked out of bounds, will stay with Kansas. Jayhawks right now on an 8-2 run.
Take a look at that last play. He's fighting Will Walker off, gets right to the paint and explodes to the basket. That's that football mentality, Lou, right there. He will not be denied.
And he's 5'11", but 200 pounds. Chalmers on the line. Jayhawks with their sixth turnover. Here comes Klinkscales back. Klinkscales on the floor right now with Chandler, Clark, Mejia, and Green as Walker takes a seat.
Cliff Klinkscales is a game changer with his tempo, but really hasn't been able to use it thus far early. DePaul needs to get a miss and try to push and get some easy looks because they're struggling right now in the half-court offense.
Clark's fadeaway jumper falls. Light up again. Wright needs help, loses it. Khan gets it back. Nice ball movement by the Jayhawks. Robinson's three in and out. There again, had it, lost it, and gets it back, and now he's fouled. Good effort there by Robinson, forcing Mejia into the foul. Log on to your online source for all things college sports, ESPNU.com. This online gateway will connect you to all the college sports content from ESPN. Log on to ESPNU.com today. We are college sports.
What a fortunate sequence that time for Kansas. DePaul played outstanding defense. Happened to have two guys going after the basketball, didn't come up with it, but that's got to be encouraging for Jerry Wainwright.
Yeah, defense they haven't run this season. Khan throws it up, gets the miss, and lays it up and in. Boy, Sasha Khan looks much better today than he has the last three games.
Much more aggressive, and Wesley Green, he's got to match his intensity there. Wesley, a very talented young man, but sort of an enigma to Jerry Wainwright. Some days he looks like a pro, and then others you don't know where he is.
Khan with great defense there rejects it, and you're right about Wesley Green. Shot clock, by the way, down to 13. They try to get it to Chandler. Here comes Kansas. Collins for three, missed everything. Clark had it, knocked around.
Darrell Arthur took a nasty spill that time. He got back up, but he's a little woozy underneath the basket.
Green up and no. Chandler tried, no. Green again, loses it. Bodies all over the floor. Great effort there by both sides.
What?
Crowd wanted a foul call. They're not going to get it. Wesley Green working hard. Sasha Khan there to reject it. Kansas leads DePaul by a bucket, 17-15. Jayhawks have won 21 of their last 24 games. Wesley Green at the free throw line. Foul was on Sharon Collins just before the timeout.
DePaul's got to be pleased with that last effort on the glass. You had Wilson, Chandler, Mejia, and Green all battling for the offensive rebound. When you're struggling offensively to find some continuity, those easy stick backs can get you through tough times.
And you had a good point. You talked about Green being an enigma coming out of Florida. He was Mr. Florida in high school. And so far here at DePaul, he's averaging just 4.5 points and 2.5 rebounds a game. They need more from a guy that's 6'9", 295.
With really good skill set as well. And he's had trouble with his weight. And so conditioning has been a problem. And if he can get that under control and get his weight under control, this is a very talented young man. And he's got the bloodlines, Lou. His father played professionally overseas. I played against him. Kenny could flat out play.
Rush your shot in and out. Yeah, as dad played in the NBA, spent some time in Washington, Philadelphia, was a terrific player at Wake Forest as well.
That's right. Kenny Green had mad hops, boy.
I bet you took him to school.
No.
Come on.
I had to avoid him in the paint. I stayed outside shooting jumpers. I wasn't fooling with him.
Shot clock now under 10. Chandler tried to get it to Klingscales. Chalmers had it and lost it out of bounds. Chalmers, a guy you need to be careful. This guy, one of the top defensive players, leads the team with 14 steals coming in. That's his 15th.
Well, and he's 6'1", but his wingspan is that of a 6'5" player. Extremely long arms. He's quick. He's playing the passing lanes that time. Kansas is just a tough, tough team to try to penetrate against. Looks like we got some clock issues. Jim Byrne, one of the best in the business, over there getting it straightened out.
6:20 on the game clock.
One thing I like about this officiating crew that we had this afternoon, you're looking at Jim Byrne right there, but Ted Hillary also. These are two of the best in the business.
Tied at 17 while we're waiting. Women's college basketball. Bluegrass State battle on ESPN here. There tomorrow afternoon, 24th ranked Kentucky takes on Louisville. Women's college basketball on ESPNU tomorrow at 1 o'clock Eastern. And don't forget, for more information, go log on to ESPNU.com.
As they're sorting this out, Lou, I'm looking at the stats, and it doesn't look like much, but Sasha Kahn is 2 of 3 coming off the bench with 4 points, but those are really effort points that got his team going, doing a good job off the bench, whereas Butler came in, and we were concerned about his conditioning, and it showed. Really struggled the few minutes that he was on the floor.
DePaul with just 5 seconds on the shot clock now, because Kansas never had possession of it. Klingscales throws it up. DePaul never got into its offense, which is a bad mistake on the Blue Demons' part, because they had a timeout to discuss it.
And it's unfortunate. Klingscales is quick, Lou. I can't stress that enough. And in that situation, he didn't use his quickness. He could have taken it to the basket a little bit more. Maybe he had the defense conversion, possibly had one of his teammates over.
Wainwright showing that he wasn't happy with him. Sits him on the bench. So Walker's back.
Kansas running their high-low offense, where Arthur and Jackson will alternate positions on the paint and in the high post.
Jackson walks with it. 7th turnover for Kansas.
And Jackson there making the move. He's really the third big man. When Giles was kicked off the team, it really put Bill Self in a bind. They were expecting Jackson to be the third big man, but he's having to really play extensive minutes.
Clark had it stripped away, going to the bucket. Chalmers at the other end. Arthur, double team. Needs help. Calls a timeout. Good defense there from DePaul. Thompson and Mejia trap the freshman, Darrell Arthur, who averages just under 16 points and 7 rebounds a game.
Take a look at the last play. You see Arthur. Good job by DePaul. The off big man is coming to double team, whether it's Wright or Arthur on the post. They're not going to double team Jackson. Jackson, not a tremendous scorer at about 8 points a game, but they're going to double team Wright and Arthur. They can keep those guys from getting off early. That bodes well for the Demons.
Bill Self, as I said earlier, picked up a nice new 5-year contract.
You can tell with that nice shiny suit he's got on, too.
We had a chance to spend some time with Coach Self last night. You actually have a very good relationship with Coach Self, going back to your Illinois days. And obviously, Bill Self, head coach at Illinois for 3 very good years.
Outstanding job in Champaign. I liken it to bringing the program out of the ice ages. One of these new wave coaches that knows how to recruit, knows how to coach, that can respond and communicate to his players.
Robinson, the alley-oop to Arthur, who finishes.
We talked about the importance of Russell Robinson earlier. You just saw it there. He makes eye contact with Arthur. Nothing needs to be said. Arthur goes right to the hole. Beautiful half-court execution.
Self calls Robinson the glue of this team.
You need those guys that want to play defense, that want to lead the ball club, that like setting up their teammates. Russell Robinson is that guy.
Thompson back out to Walker. Mejia, he'll need to do something quickly. Shot clock down to five. Pulls up, takes the three, short. Burns tracks down the miss.
You see, DePaul pulls it back out. They've got the floor spread very nicely.
Thompson working on it. Throws it up, hits the side of the backboard.
And right now, good pass on the interior.
Mistake down low defensively for DePaul, because once Wright got it, he was all by himself.
Take a look. There's Russell Robinson. You see the eye contact with Arthur. That's what happens when guys penetrate the lane. It causes the defense to break down. You got to come help, leaving someone open. Russell doing a fine job thus far getting his teammates involved.
You look at Robinson's numbers, they're not great. Averages about 7 points a game, 3 rebounds a contest, 5 assists a ball game. But then you look and he played 43 of 45 minutes against Florida. That in itself tells you how important he is to Bill Self.
Stabilizer on the floor. The young guys look to him for the leadership. And one of those tough New York guards in Russell Robinson.
Out of Rice High School, New York City.
Chandler's got to get involved for DePaul. He's not getting a lot of touches. Then you try to find him along the baseline, give him some room to operate.
He had 5 quick points, but has held silent since. Butler needed help, and there's Chandler. Mejia on the baseline. DePaul gives it up. 10th turnover for the Blue Demons. They trail by 3.
He's an encyclopedia of love and wealth of information for these young people, and he loves impacting his student athletes.
His team leads by 9 as we start the second half. Chalmers, Robinson, Arthur, Wright, and Rush on the floor for Kansas. Wright walks with it. 9 turnovers for the Jayhawks.
Julian, if you look at his facial expressions, he appears to just be in a little bit of a daze. He hasn't quite gotten into the rhythm of the game yet, but fortunately for him, his ball club is still up 9.
He opened up a lot of eyes with his performance as Walker's 3 hits the front of the rim. His performance against top-ranked Florida last Saturday. Chalmers throws it up. This time Rush will take a crack at it. In and out.
Good defense that time in the paint by Green, holding his ground, forcing Chalmers into a tough shot.
Mejia for 3. Back of the iron. Rush pushes it up, finds Chalmers on the wing. Back to Rush. Great ball movement.
Rush is looking at the officials like he got hit on that shot.
Mejia throws it up, but draws the foul from Chalmers. Mejia will go to the line and shoot 2. So now early on here in the first minute for the second half, Mejia has been much more aggressive.
Yeah, Mejia trying to get to the basket, and the majority of opportunities that DePaul has had this afternoon have been from outside. They've been on jumpers. Not much going to the basket. I'm sure that's what Coach Wainwright emphasized. You can see Coach there scratching his head. Boy, these guys live and die on each shot, each play.
Mejia with the free throws. You know, Bill Self pointed out, I know that we're the heavy favorite going into this game, but, you know, Jerry Wainwright coached a Richmond team 3 seasons ago that upset Kansas in Lawrence. But then Wainwright came back and said, yeah, that Richmond team, by the way, had 3 seniors in the backcourt.
That's right. Makes a huge difference. And I'm sure Coach Wainwright got into the locker room. He's going to make some halftime adjustments.
Robinson loses it. Green gets it out to Mejia. Mejia all the way to the bucket, tried to make something happen, and he did again. Second foul in a minute on Chalmers.
Very fortunate that time, though. Mejia going 1-on-3, trying to force the issue, and he's so good at probing on the bounce. You see him going the hole. He's got kind of got that herky-jerky movement going to the basket. Very tough to stop.
Mejia misses the first. One of only four players in DePaul history to record 1,000 points, 400 rebounds, 300 assists in a Blue Demons uniform.
When you're at home and you're trying to close the deficit, your best player has got to nail those free throws to try to get the home crowd back into the game.
He's had a tough time from the line so far this year, just 62% coming in. This is a pair there. Arthur pulls up. Short. We've seen a much more active Wesley Green on the defensive end for DePaul here in the early moments.
Did a good job there. Darrell Arthur doing what he should in trying to use his athleticism, but Green didn't give up on the play.
Poked away there by Chalmers, goes out of bounds. We'll stay with DePaul.
No, neither team has really gotten into any kind of flow here in the second half. Kansas yet to scratch.
Chandler working on right. Burns on the floor for DePaul. Mejia against Rush. Steps on the line. So Mejia again trying to do something, trying to force the issue by going to the bucket, but good defense there by Rush, who pushed him towards the baseline.
Well, Sammy's got to understand that the worst time to try to go one-on-one is when you first catch the ball. He's got five defenders watching him.
Wright lays it up and in. What a feed from Rush.
Boy, that sophomore tandem right there is something to see. Rush going to the basket, drawing the defense, and kicking to a wide open right.
Green against Arthur. Throws it up too hard off the glass. Mejia back up with it. Doesn't go. Has another shot. Yes. Finally gets it to go.
And that's one of the things that's kept DePaul in this game is their ability to hit the offensive glass.
Chalmers makes it a 10-point game thanks to the three. He has 9.
Chalmers 3-of-3 from deep today. Really found the range early. And he's taking good shots, Luke.
Burns trying to free himself. Again, it was Chalmers taking the spill. Third time he's done that in this game.
We have to check his what he's studying in Kansas. I'm sure he's got some drama in there somewhere because he's doing a good job on the defensive end of drawing charges.
By the way, before that Mejia bucket, Stephen, it had been 11 minutes, 40 seconds since DePaul had scored a field goal. All the way to the bucket, Robinson.
Woo, nice hesitation dribble by Robinson with his offhand. Got all the way to the bucket.
Jerry Wainwright calls a timeout. Kansas with its biggest lead in this game, 33-21. Russell Robinson, the junior, taking matters into his own hands. Fifth-ranked Kansas by a dozen over DePaul here in the second half, 33-21.
See if DePaul can find someone with a hot hand. Will Walker stroking it from three early.
Wilson Chandler with the basketball. He averages 15 a game. He has only 3. What have they done defensively against Chandler?
Just really made it tough on him, trying to keep him away from the basket, keep him on the perimeter, and force him to beat them over the top. Chandler just hasn't found any rhythm, only 1 of 7 from the field.
Blue Demons just 1 for 6 here in the second half. Robinson for 3. Clark pulls down the miss, and he's fouled by Arthur. Darrell Arthur, the foul. That's his first. Another timeout. 12-point game. Thank you. Kansas up by 12 over DePaul. The alley-oop to Chandler. He finally got involved.
Nice look that time. A 1-4 set along the free throw line. Jabari Curry looks away the defense. Chandler starts up, goes hard to the bucket. That'll get you going.
Chalmers to the bucket, lays it up and in. Just the second field goal, by Chandler, by the way.
This is what hurts DePaul right now when every time Kansas scores, they're able to go back and set up in their defense. If DePaul can get some stops and some fast break looks, I think it could get them going.
Chandler's jumper wouldn't go. Rush lost it, and Curry there. Poked away again. Chalmers goes out of bounds. Chalmers collided with Clark, and he's on the ground.
Take a look. You see right there, Curry with a beautiful pass at the bucket. 1-4 set. Chandler fakes like he's coming out to get the ball, runs back door, and leaves Julian right in his shoes there. Nice pass by Curry over the top of the defense.
Curry, a sophomore out of Detroit, Michigan, actually started at the point guard spot to open up the season, but Will Walker has started the last three games.
And Walker, really, Coach Wainwright feels, will be the point guard of the future for this ball club. The type of leadership skills that he is looking for at that position.
Two point guards on the floor in Walker and Curry. Hurd shoots the jumper. Collins all the way to the bucket. And Robinson is tripped up by Curry.
Well, Collins is going to the hole. He's being aggressive every time he gets it. He's looking to get all the way to the bucket, putting pressure on the Blue Demons defensively. And then the other guard, Russell, comes up with the offensive rebound. That's just hustle. Better on the side of Kansas right now.
Collins feeling more and more comfortable out there on the floor. Played a season-high 26 minutes against Ball State before that Florida contest. Right underneath. What a feed from Rush. No-look pass down low to the big fella who finished it.
And you saw those two hook up in that monster Florida game. Same deal. Rush feeding right. Right being able to feed Rush.
Foul take a look, Robinson.
Take a look at that last play. Rush goes so hard to the basket. Wright's man has to come over and provide help. Guard doesn't rotate on the backside. Julian Wright open.
14-point game, 37-23. Kansas vying for its sixth consecutive win. Chandler hits the three. Very good three-point shooter, 52%. From three-point range coming in. That's his 13th this season.
Nice set play by DePaul to find Chandler one-on-one on the weak side.
The foul's on Julian Wright, trying to set a pick on Mejia.
We didn't pick it up right there, but you saw the back screen that freed Chandler up, kind of a misdirection play. Good job by Chandler taking advantage of his number being called.
Chandler with 10 shots taken in this game. That's what his coach wants to see.
And they just tried to run the same play, but Sharon Collins defensively made Burns turn his back, so it threw the timing of the play off.
Curry throws up the floater and it goes.
Curry using his height advantage in the paint.
The ball within nine. Kansas almost threw it away. Rush out near the timeline. Rush open for three. Curry takes down the miss. We get it to Chandler. Chandler needs help. He double dribbled. I was just getting ready to say he picked up his dribble and boom, he put it back on the floor.
Yeah, that seems like Wilson wants to do so much. He wants it so bad. Trying to force the issue. But this is the end of the court that DePaul's got to make a stance here.
Collins all the way to the bucket. Arthur's shot wouldn't go. Kahn had it and pulled away by Hurd.
Now right now, the crowd wants to explode for the Blue Demons. It's important that they get a bucket here.
Mejia. Over to Hurd. Around Kahn. Back to Mejia. Has it rejected. Goes out of bounds. It will stay with DePaul. 18 on the shot clock.
I like that action on the offensive end by DePaul. They're getting penetration now, Lou. They're looking for their guys along the baseline. Marcus Hurd providing that energy off the bench.
Chalmers back. Rush on the bench.
Boy, these guys haven't figured out. You cannot lay any passes out on the flat when Mario Chalmers lurking. Plays the passing lanes as well as any guard in the country. And we've seen him deflect four passes this afternoon.
He was the most outstanding player in the Big 12 championship last year. It was terrific. Burns takes the shot and hits the three. It's a six-point game.
And that's what Draylen Burns can do, can come off the bench a la Vinny style from Detroit. Vinny Johnson style, the microwave off the bench.
Well, Jerry Wainwright told us at practice on Thursday that Draylen Burns just lays in bed at night, looks up at his ceiling, and dreams of being Vinny Johnson. Exactly, the microwave.
The microwave, and he's a guy that hasn't seen a shot he doesn't like. Boy, you see Bill Self right now giving it to his guys.
What's he telling his guys right now? What's he not happy about?
He's not happy with the way that they have not executed in the second half. And we'll look at the last play, but you see him trying to urge his guys to get into the flow of the game. And right there, Burns comes off a screen from Chandler, and Draylen makes them pay. Bouncing back, telling the guys in Kansas, didn't you read the scouting report? This is what I do best.
Well, I'll tell you what, he's been hot of late as we look at the three-point shooting. DePaul 5 for 12 from three-point range. Burns in his last two games averaging 16.5 points a game. Now, DePaul hasn't played since November 22nd. Those efforts came in Hawaii at the Maui Invitational.
That's right.
DePaul on a 10-2 run right now. And now this crowd's into it. They were lulled to sleep by the Jayhawks defense there in the first half. Chalmers looking for room, throws it up and in. Boy, he can really silence the crowd, can he?
Yes, he can. And Chalmers has an assortment of runners and floaters in the paint. Now we just got a view of one of those right there.
Quietly, he's put up 13 on the Blue Demons today.
His shot selection has been terrific.
Collins almost had the steal. Burton throws it up off the glass and it'll go to the line.
But I'm looking at the body language of the guys on the floor for DePaul. They're not excited.
I think the crowd's more fired up about the burn shot than the players. Timeout, 39-33 DePaul. DePaul with an opportunity to creep within five. Draylen Burns will go to the line. Fifth-ranked Kansas. 39-33, Wilson Chandler has become much more effective the last 4 minutes.
He's getting active, and it's the effort on the defensive end that can feed the offensive end. And right there you see the dunk on the alley-oop to start the second half. But Coach Wainwright told us in practice a couple days ago, Lou, his team, if they're not playing well offensively, sometimes it affects the way they play on the defensive end, and it should be the other way around. Defense starts everything. The intensity on the defensive end can spur you to do a lot of good things on the offensive end of the floor.
Burns misses the free throw. So we've seen Mejia miss a couple of free throws. Burns miss a free throw there. We'll see if those come back to haunt the Blue Demons.
Nice job by Mejia. Keeping Chalmers away from the basketball.
Robinson finds Collins for three, and he hits.
Boy, nice inside action. And once again, it's Russell Robinson setting up his teammates.
Burns and Collins tangled up down low. Foul is called on Collins. Third foul on Collins. Fifth-ranked Kansas in the DePaul. We're at Allstate Arena in Rosemont. here on ESPNU. I'm Luke Kanellis. Steve Imbardo's alongside. DePaul got off to a nice start, led 8-6. Then Kansas turned the screws defensively, closed the first half up 26-17. Blue Demons with a run here in the second half. They closed as close as 6.
Draylen Burns is giving that needed boost off the bench. The activity, you see the defensive end now, they start to pick it up. See how they're pressing the basketball now, forcing Kansas a little bit further than they want to be initially.
They've done it with a smaller lineup as well. Butler, Green, both on the bench, along with Lorenzo Thompson. Robinson hits the three. He has 6.
Tell you what, he does a lot that's not going to show up on the stat sheet, but that's a timely three for him. DePaul's starting to get some rhythm, and Russell takes it in stride and drains the three.
Mejia drawed the double team. Arthur called for the foul. Log on your online source for all things college sports, ESPNU.com. This online gateway will connect you to all the college sports content from ESPN. Log on to ESPNU.com. We are college sports. That time, Mejia hits the free throw. He's now in double figures with 10.
Well, Mejia's been aggressive here in the second half, really drawing fouls and trying to get to the free throw line. That's another way to get your confidence going, Lewis, to see a couple go through at the bucket, at the free throw line, gives you confidence to extend your game.
And the longer DePaul can hang in this game, the more confidence they'll have down the stretch. Curry commits the foul on Robinson. Second foul on Curry, 14 foul. Jerry Wainwright. 13th season as a head coach. He's taken his teams to 3 NCAA tournaments and 3 NITs.
Boy, Julian Wright just really lacking confidence right now.
Burns tried to block out Wright. Wright got on his back and they called a foul on Burns. So right to the free throw line.
And like Mejia on the other end, as we look at this play here, you see the pick and roll. Nice job. Chandler stays with the ball and doesn't go with Julian Wright. Fortunate for DePaul, Draylen Burns tries to come down and help, but Julian just too athletic at the basket.
Right, a 65% free throw shooter. Big 12 player of the week last week after his performance against Florida. Hits a pair. He now is in double figures with 10. And it's a 10-point game.
Kansas showing you what some of the better teams in the country do when teams make a run on them.
Right over the defense, the pass went from Burns to Mejia. Robinson frees himself up for 3. Burns pulls down the miss. Arthur takes a spill. The DePaul crowd wanted a foul call. Caron Clark trying to get involved offensively. No, but there's Mejia. And Mejia showing some emotion.
That's what this DePaul ball club needs. Some guys who want to get out here and get after it. Now the crowd's in the game.
6-point game, Stephen. Everyone on their feet here. Knocked away by Mejia. Lost it for a second. All the way. Has it rejected. What a play by Robinson, who got back on defense.
Boy, this is what the fans wanted to see. Up and down action.
Collins tripped up by Burns. Wow. How about that defensive play by Robinson?
Man. Take a look at the last bucket. Caron Clark using his shoulders to get some space in there. And then Mejia showing his length at the hole. But Robinson, like, not today, young fella.
You and I talked about how good a rebounder he was, averaging almost 4 rebounds a game. Man, he can get up there.
Yes, he can.
6'1", 200. There's right to the bucket off the glass. No.
Boy, Julian is really struggling this afternoon. Those are point-blank looks that he was cashing in last week out in Vegas. Seems to just not be his day this afternoon. Okay, now DePaul doesn't know. They're just going one-on-one.
Burns needs help. Finds Chandler. Break into the bucket. Throws it up. It didn't go, but he'll go to the line. Boy, the roof in this place would have blown right off if that shot fell.
And they really want to. They've been waiting all second half to get involved in the game. And we talked about the emotion of the DePaul players. They're finally starting to show some emotion, and it's translating in opportunities here on the offensive end.
Last time DePaul was that this close, which is now 47-42. 2 minutes remained in the first half.
Right now, Coach Wainwright trying to steal a couple minutes for Chandler. Going to bring the big fella, Keith Butler, in the game. Watch DePaul go to a 2-3 zone.
Four-point lead for the fifth-ranked Jayhawks. Jackson double-team. Turns it over. Good defense there. Butler and Hurd draped all over him.
You don't expect Darnell Jackson, the junior out of Oklahoma City, knows better than to go along the baseline to the double-team. But Hurd again involved in one of those effort plays, paying dividends for the Demons.
Curry tried to get around Wright. Wright called for the reach. DePaul has crept back within four, 47-43. They are on their feet, sold out crowd here outside of Chicago. Fifth-ranked Kansas leads DePaul 47-43, but the Blue Demons have crept back in this game. They trail by as many as a dozen, just like the old days here at Allstate Arena.
Getting it going and getting the fans into it. You see over there the young fella getting his two-step on. Getting down there for the camera. But this crowd was just waiting to get into this ball game, Lou. And once again, we talk about the effort plays. Marcus Hurd comes off the bench. Jabari Curry makes a good pass to Wilson Chandler, does a good job. They come up with a strip on Chalmers a little while ago.
Draylen Burns off the bench.
So all of these effort plays, it's not necessarily the offense, it's the effort that's gotten DePaul back into this game.
But you told me at DePaul's practice on Thursday, you thought DePaul matched up well with Kansas.
Yes, they do. They have the athleticism. They're one of the more athletic teams in the country, but they just haven't found a way to put 40 minutes of tough effort together. But right now, they're bringing it.
Blue Demons with a record of 2-4 coming in. Slow start for Jerry Wainwright's crew. Sammy Mejia getting ready to come back. That's four free throws the Blue Demons have missed now.
As a team, they shoot just over 65%. And when you're trying to climb back in games at home, that's why they're called free throws. You gotta knock them down.
Again, he misses, and now Hurd is called for the foul. DePaul 10 for 15 from the free throw line.
But they're starting to get, as we look at the 3-point field goals right there, DePaul's starting to get more opportunities at the free throw line. That means that they are attacking the glass despite the block advantage that Kansas has, 6-0 in their favor.
They truly have been the aggressor here in the second half. Double bonus for the Blue Demons. Kansas, 10 team fouls. DePaul with six. Rush on the baseline, off the glass, doesn't get the roll. Hurd grabs it and puts two arms around it.
Boy, there's been a top on that basket down there for Kansas the last 4 minutes. They've had three opportunities right at the basket, just not fall for them.
Curry, Hurd, Clark, Chandler, and Mejia on the floor for DePaul. What a fired pass there from Curry to Hurd. 2-point game.
Nice pick and roll. Chandler starts in the basket, comes away, takes the weak side help. And Marcus Hurd wide open underneath the basket. Nice execution of the pick and roll.
DePaul scored 10 of the last 12 points. Robinson finds Chalmers. Looking for room. Right. He takes the three. Robinson tracks it down. Right, right into the bucket, throws it down with one hand.
That's to get the young fella from Chicago Heights into the game. Right there. Those second chance opportunities on the glass. DePaul is doing a pretty good job early. Broke down that time.
And Curry gives it up. Tried to get it out to Chalmers. On the floor, Curry. Was sliding on the floor with the basketball and his call for the travel.
Take a look here. There's the opportunity there by Russell. And Sammy Mejia doesn't stay with Wright as he gets to the basket. But that's what good teams do, Lou. They find a way to beat you. Whether it's on second chance points, defensive pressure, as we see the turnover count right there. But Kansas showing you their mettle right now, and their fans are flexing their muscles.
And this place near sellout. 18,500, half the crowd, at least Kansas fans. The miss, right, right place, right time. Rush,
yeah!
Threw it up over to Arthur for the jam.
Kansas taking advantage of Keith Butler in the game right now. Doesn't have the foot speed to close off penetration. Good job of penetration and dishing off that time by Kansas.
Timeout for Jerry Wainwright. Good evening still with two timeouts left. Jayhawks three. 51-45, fifth-ranked Kansas in front. Head coach Bill Self. Fourth season at Kansas. He's already won a couple of regular season Big 12 titles and a Big 12 tournament championship. On the other side, Jerry Wainwright, trying to get the Blue Demon program to a championship level. Women's college basketball on ESPNU tomorrow, 1 o'clock Eastern. Bluegrass State battle between number 24 Kentucky and Louisville. Again, 1 o'clock Eastern. More information, log on to ESPNU.com. Just a moment ago, Darrell Arthur getting it done.
The freshman right there, defensively, you see there he holds his ground. Then he takes a sweet dime from Russell Robinson and knows what to do with it. And another one from Rush. It looked like Rush shot an air ball, but that was a planned alley-oop. And you look at Darrell's numbers, picking up where he left off from the Dartmouth game.
Below his season average, though, he averages 16 a game and just under 7 rebounds a contest.
They were trying to run the same play to get Wilson Chandler a shot, a three-point opportunity. And Will Walker picked the ball up a little bit too early, and he's getting a mouthful by Wainwright.
DePaul shooting 33% inside the arc, 42% outside the arc.
A lot of that has to do with the defense of Kansas. And they don't know the shot clock running down, 5 seconds.
Shot clock down to three. Burns will have to throw it up. He does. Not the shot they were looking for.
That's where DePaul misses a true veteran point guard. A coach on the floor that's going to scream that out to let his teammates know.
Robinson fouled going to the bucket by Walker.
Will Walker looks like he's going to be a good one, but it's tough to expect freshmen in their seventh game in their career in college to be able to handle the pressure of a game like this one against a tough team in Kansas.
He takes a seat on the bench. Today was his third collegiate start. So you're right. Still very young. But the point guard of the future for the Blue Demons as Robinson knocks down the first free throw. He now has 7. Back to a 7-point lead for the Jayhawks.
Kansas methodically pushing the lead back to where it was previously. Just attacking the glass. They're starting to do some set plays in the half court, freeing up their big men along the baseline. And Robinson taking advantage of the free throw.
Chandler. That's Clark. Clark takes the three, and he's fouled. He'll shoot three free throws. Robinson caught him on the arm.
I'm laughing because I'm looking at the bench of Kansas, and they are not happy with that play. And you look here. Oh, yeah, he got him right on the elbow. And Clark wouldn't have shot an air ball from the corner. He's struggling from the three this year thus far. Only 28%, but he has the ability to knock those down. So when you see a player of his magnitude come up with an air ball, more than likely got hit on the shot.
DePaul 11 for 16 from the stripe. Huge opportunity here. Butler comes back. Heard to the bench. Butler reinstated on Monday. This is his first game this season. He was suspended since June. Big 7-1 presence now in the middle for DePaul, but playing sporadically in this contest, still fighting to get in shape.
2-3 zone by DePaul. Watch the inside out action from Kansas. They'll try to hit Julian Wright.
Collins tries to split the defense, gets it out to Robinson. Collins takes the three. No. Chandler. All the way, throws it up with one hand, and it goes.
Ooh, he was fortunate that time that he got that shot down.
Three-point game. Jerry Wainwright looking at Wilson Chandler, hugging him, saying, I didn't think it was going to go. But it did.
Boy, he had a nice look. Sammy Mejia was along the baseline. You see here Wilson Chandler bringing the rock up. Mejia's not in your picture on the right side. Degree of difficulty, 9.9 on that shot there by Wilson Chandler.
Wilson Chandler named to the Big East All-Rookie team last year. Second team All-Big East Conference. Much expected out of the sophomore this year from Benton Harbor, Michigan. 53-50. DePaul in front. Chandler 9 of 12 here in the second half. So he's really been aggressive here in the second half.
And Chandler is very tough upbringing in Benton Harbor. And Coach Wainwright loves this young man. Said that he's learning every day on and off the court with unlimited potential.
Chalmers. With defenders. Arthur threw it up, no, and Butler grabs the rebound. Even in the sporadic minutes that Butler's provided, he's done a nice job of standing his own down low and grabbing key rebounds.
He really has, and you just can't teach the size that he's bringing. You see him laying his body on people, trying to free his teammates up.
Mejia for three, we're tied at 53.
This is what Bill Self was trying to tell his team. Don't look at the record of the DePaul Blue Demons. They're going to be ready to play this afternoon. They fought a lot of adversity. They didn't score for 11 straight minutes, but they find themselves a little bit more over 2 minutes, right back in the ball game.
Mejia called for the foul. This after one of the biggest threes of his collegiate career for the Blue Demons. We are all tied up. Last time DePaul beat a team ranked amongst the top five in the country, February 6th of 1999, 61-60 overtime winner over third-ranked Cincinnati. They've got Kansas on the ropes now. Here's our Star Watch update. Sammy Mejia with 18, 13 coming in the second half. Julian Wright for the Jayhawks, a dozen.
And Julian really has struggled most of the afternoon. He's in double figures, but really never found the rhythm offensively. And right now, Sammy Mejia, big three right there to get the crowd back into it and even the ball game up for DePaul. But he's got to be smarter on the defensive end. He's taking the momentum of the crowd out with a foul 40 feet away from the basket.
And he puts Brandon Rush on the free throw line. Rush has struggled from the line this season, just 50%. Burns, Clark, Chandler, all helping in the comeback for DePaul. That's Curry handling the basketball. Gets it to Clark.
Run another set play for Chandler. He's one-on-one.
Working on right, finds Mejia for three again. Yes, sir! DePaul's back in front.
We said it earlier, Sammy Mejia plays best when the lights are brightest. Boy, he left it. He brought his A game here in the second half.
Right off the glass, too hard. Under 2 minutes. DePaul is on an 11-0 run.
You see, Kansas starting to press a little bit on the half-court set. They're not taking their time like they were in the earlier part of the second half. Starting to rush a little bit. Look for a pick and roll with Sammy Mejia and Wilson Chandler.
Chop off down the six. Mejia against Rush. Spins. Fade away. Yes, sir, Reed.
Oh, he's feeling it. He's feeling it right now.
Are you kidding me? He is on fire, and this place is buzzing. The Blue Demons have the fifth-ranked Jayhawks on the ropes. Up by five, 58-53, 1:18 left. DePaul still with two timeouts left. Kansas with one timeout, and Mejia has been on fire here in the second half.
Sammy Mejia has put the team on his back. You see right here, we'll take a look at that last shot that he was able to take. He gets on the offensive glass, and that's the emotion that Coach Wainwright wants to see. There's the three that ties the ball game, and then once you got a guy going like Sammy Mejia, everything looks a lot easier. That basket opens up, and look at this shot right here. Double team, step back, nothing but cotton for the guard out of New York.
His pregame ritual is to take a nap. He is wide awake now, and he's got the crowd here. Near sellout, 18,500 inside Allstate Arena. Rosemont, Illinois, just outside of Chicago. Last time DePaul knocked off a top five opponent. I was here. They beat third-ranked Cincinnati 61-60 in overtime back in February of 1999.
Now, if you're Kansas, there's plenty of time in this game. 1:18, only down five. You've got Chalmers on the floor right now, who is 3 of 3 from three. Robinson 1 of 4, so these guys are capable of getting back in this game quickly.
Robinson working on Curry, draws the foul, so Robinson will go to the line. 19 fouling DePaul, so Robinson will shoot the 1 and 1. Curry's been terrific off the bench. We talked about it earlier in the broadcast. Jabari Curry, a sophomore, led this team in assists last season, but Will Walker, the freshman, inserted into the starting lineup for DePaul 3 games ago. Curry has not sulked a second. Robinson misses the free throw, and Hurd grabs the miss. And Arthur's called for the foul.
You know what's surprising, Lou, is that we're not seeing the poise of Kansas that we saw
in the Florida game.
In the Florida
just a week ago.
Or the Dartmouth game where they were dominant.
They crushed Dartmouth by 51.
Right. And DePaul has something to do with it, but these guys seem tight. They're not taking advantage of the free throw line. Robinson did a good job of drawing a foul. They had the opportunity to score with no time off the clock. They just didn't convert.
UAB Cincinnati coming up at the conclusion of our game here on ESPNU. Right now, Jerry Wainwright's Blue Demons lead Kansas by 5, 58-53. Marcus Hurd at the free throw line. Hits the first.
Marcus Hurd scored 3 points on the afternoon, looking for his fourth, but for his contribution has been huge, especially here in the second half. He's come up with some monster defensive rebounds. He's a solid player, can hit the jumper, knows how to pass. One of those guys you need on the floor at this time.
He's a co-captain for the Blue Demons. Misses the second, had a season-high 11 points against Kentucky and Maui. Under a minute to go. 6-point lead.
DePaul switching defensively, doing a really good job.
Kansas is confused out there. Chalmers breaking to the bucket is fouled. And Chalmers will go to the line. Chalmers tried to make something happen as DePaul switched up defensively. Nice job on your part to point that out.
Well, that's the advantage of a team like DePaul. They've got four or five guys all similar height. Curry, Burns 6'4", Clark 6'5", Marcus Hurd 6'6", and Chandler 6'8". So they have the ability to switch on perimeter defense and really nullify any set play that Kansas is trying to do right now.
Chalmers with another free throw. These Jayhawks a year ago opened up the season 3-4 before finishing 25-8. Six of their eight losses were by 4 points or less. So they are used to situations like this that go down to the wire.
And now you'll see the pressure. They may look for a steal here in the half court set. If they don't get it here in the half court, then they'll foul. Oh, they got Chandler where they want him.
They foul Clark. Clark, a 60% free throw shooter, will go to the line at the other end.
Boy, these Blue Demons have shown some moxie here in the second half, Lou. They looked dead in the water towards the end of the first half, couldn't get anything going. And they came out in the second half and brought the energy level that Coach Wainwright talked about that they're trying to get to each and every night. And boy, it's paid off for them here, coming down the stretch.
Mark hits the free throw. Arthur comes back. Collins takes a seat for Kansas.
Butler has really surprised me with the amount of time he's been able to play this afternoon. I was concerned with his conditioning.
Misses the second. Two-possession game. Chalmers around Burns. Finds Robinson on the wing. In and out. Knocked around. Mejia comes down with it. Over the timeline. DePaul. Spreading out the floor. This place is buzzing. They feel an upset in the making. Burns will go to the line.
What a job by DePaul that time. Keeping the ball out of each other, passing the ball around the perimeter, avoiding the foul, and having precious time tick off the clock. Very good execution that time by Sammy Mejia to start that sequence off.
Marcus Hurd back to the free throw line. 1-for-2 from the charity stripe today.
Coach Self thinks that's five fouls, so he's looking for a substitute. But it's only his fourth, okay.
Right, Chalmers, Rush, Robinson, and Arthur. Hurd at the line. It's a very young Kansas team. Despite being one of the most talented in the country, this is a team, we talked about it earlier, three sophomore, one freshman, one junior. They don't have a senior on this team, so they lack a leader. Coming up, UAB and Cincinnati. Hurd hits the free throws. 7-point lead.
Watch for the quick three.
Repossession game. Chalmers throws up the three. Our third error to score. Timeout.
So Kansas is going to look for the full court pressure to try the steal.
Top of the broadcast, we told you that they're honoring the legendary Ray Meyer during today's game. Coach passed away last March on St. Patrick's Day at the age of 92. A number of his former players here to participate in the festivities for the coach. 34 of Coach Ray's 42 teams are represented today, and he would be proud of this Blue Demons effort, wouldn't he?
He really would. Team that really just fought and rolled their sleeves up here in the second half. And honoring him with a great effort against a very good Kansas team. And their effort in the second half, talking about DePaul, really nullified the quickness and athleticism that we saw early in the game. Remember, DePaul was trying to get to the basket as we look at career numbers for Ray Meyer, but DePaul was trying to get to the basket early. Nothing was going. Couldn't score for a long time, and all of a sudden, they get a couple plays on the defensive end and turn the tide. The crowd gets into it, and they ride the wave of emotion here coming down the stretch.
Talk to me about the mid-majors and the way they've played against the top dogs in college basketball so far this season. We've seen so many mid-majors pull off the upset. Kansas, with no timeouts left, DePaul was still a couple. Possession arrow in favor of the Blue Demons. Butler's run. Missouri State winning. Oral Roberts knocking off this Kansas team. What does that tell you about college basketball this season, Stephen?
Well, we're seeing an example of it here this afternoon. You look at Kansas, a very young ball club. And at the top level, those programs like Kansas and Ohio State, they lose players early to the NBA. And so you have some veteran players for DePaul's side and Sammy Mejia that are able to step up in this type of situation and perform and try to knock off the big dog in this case, which is Kansas.
Sammy Mejia will inbound the basketball. Burns is fouled. They go back to the line. 5-point lead for DePaul over the fifth-ranked Jayhawks, 62-57.
Bill Self told us last night that this was the first true road test for the Jayhawks and his young squad. He didn't know how they were going to respond.
Two previous games in Las Vegas,
right.
So neutral court.
Neutral court.
And if you saw that game, it was a Jayhawks crowd.
I sure was. Draylen Burns, Milwaukee native, making good on that opportunity. And Coach Self will go back to the drawing board and use this as an example of how to come out and play every night. And on the flip side, Wainwright's got to be pleased and be able to show his club, hey, this wasn't pretty, but we got it done anyway.
They played Kentucky tough in Maui, and Coach Self told us, hey, they're not as bad as 2-4. I saw them against Kentucky. I saw them against Chaminade. And now we saw them firsthand today. DePaul has knocked off the fifth-ranked team in the country. DePaul beats Kansas 64-57. First victory for DePaul over a team ranked amongst the top five since 1999. And their first victory ever over Kansas.
See the students rush the floor and they should be happy. It's a tremendous win for the DePaul Blue Demons. A team that many think are going to do some damage in the Big East Conference.
Sammy Mejia with 23 to lead the Blue Demons. Again, the final, 64-57. For Stephen Bardo, I'm Luke Kanellis. Coming up next, UAB in Cincinnati here on ESPNU. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com. The proceeding has been an exclusive presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Now let's go to Cincinnati to Anthony Calhoun and Larry Conley.